today. First of all, let me just say thank you to everyone that has put in so much work to this weekend. And I have to give a very special thanks to Melba. Melba was somewhat, I would say, my surrogate mom in Chapelville.
I'll take that.
Particularly as I started to think about what I was going to do when I eventually had to leave Chapelville. And Prevention Partners was one of the first places that, luckily, Sam and Jeff fiercely came across as an opportunity. And I remember the first day walking in full suit. You guys are eating lunch, and I sat down just as nervous as I could be. But that initial conversation was probably the most important part of my early career. So I am completely indebted and grateful for Prevention Partners. I think it would be safe to say I'm not the only person that can say that. And I remember when Meg called to ask if I would join the board of directors. And I started to scratch my head, like, why in the world would Meg ask me to join the board of directors of all people? And I was completely elated and excited, and I had to apologize to Meg, and I told the rest of the board members this. I cut her off. I'm like, Meg, you don't have to sell me on this opportunity. Heck yeah, I'm coming back to the board of directors. But we started to talk about how we can make my joining the board purposeful. And one of the first things we talked about was strengthening the support for future interns. And I think that's a huge priority for us, and I think everyone in here would agree with that. And I think about support of our interns for a number of reasons. For one, my conversation with my parents upon having the opportunity to join the organization was very interesting. I called my dad and said, Dad, I need your help. I have this great organization I'm going to join this summer. We're going to be doing this, going to be doing that. Such a smart group of people. Everyone's real nice. He said, well, how much are they paying you, son? And I said, they're not paying me, Dad. And he says, you're going to be working for free? I said, yeah, I am. I need your help. I need your support. I need you to float me for the summer. And he did. But I think about how many people either don't have that opportunity or people who would even pass up on an opportunity in an organization like Prevention Partners because it's unpaid. And so we're going to change that. We're going to start tonight. And I think about chair the Intern Fund campaign that will officially launch on October 19th. It reminds me of a poem that is a very important part of my fraternity. And it's called Bridge Builder. And it's by William A. Drumgoole. And it goes, an old man going a lone highway, came in the evening cold and gray, to a chasm vast and deep and wide. The ridge was flowing a sullen tide. As the old man crossed in the twilight dim, the sullen stream had no fear for him. When he turned, he reached the other side, and he built a bridge to span the tide. Old man, said a fellow pilgrim near, you're wasting your time in building here. You have crossed this chasm deep and wide. Why build you a bridge to span the tide? The builder lifted his old gray head. Good friend, in the path that I've come, he said, to follow with death to me today, a youth whose feet must pass this way. This chasm that has been gnawed to me, to a fairy to youth, may a pitfall be. He too must cross in the twilight dim. Good friend, I am building this bridge for him. So I say that all to say that we are building a bridge, not to say that Prevention Partners or the experience of being in college is as treacherous as a chasm or whatever you want to call it, but it is a time that's very important for many people that are trying to figure out what in the world they want to do to change the world, to help change the world. And so Lisa and Lindsay put together a few important statistics I wanted to go over tonight. So how many interns have we hosted over the past 17 years?
It
was said a couple of times.
I'm saying, I think I heard the number earlier.
167.
167, right? About how many hours on average has each intern put in and contributed to the department? What would you guys say?
Each person?
Each person on average. Come on, statistician.
Well, 300 or 400 hours.
Hours per intern. Last year, we're not so proud about these numbers. So, summer of 2015, how many applicants did we have?
19.
Of the 19 applicants, we lost 4 because there was no financial support. I imagine.
And you don't even know those who didn't apply, probably. So.
I imagine that 19 number probably tripled, or quadrupled. Should we have funds to support future interns? And I think, and I told Nick this, I said, 17 years, 167 interns, the fact that we've been able to produce as much talent, given all of that, is completely just overwhelming and tremendous. So nonetheless, we're going to strengthen and bolster our intern program even more. And we have a goal of raising $10,000 in 6 months that will go to support one intern next summer. We have a larger goal of $20,000 for the next year. And so tonight, I will be kicking off the campaign with my contribution of $1,200. And I want everyone just to take a second to think about your experience as an intern here and what, if you could or had to place a value of it on any sorts, what would that be? You don't have to say anything, but just think about it a little bit. So, having said all that, we will be working feverishly over the next 6 months. Email, mailings, Facebook, LinkedIn, whatever magical thing that we come up with that we talked about to keep folks connected. We're going to really beat the bushes to make sure that everyone that has and can contribute will do so to help support our intern fund. So I'll stop right there and pause. I'm more than happy and so excited to talk about how we're going to build these bridges.
Well, I just wanted to say how generous that is of you. That's really amazing. This is a long-term dream of mine, was to move and Ingrid and Lindsay and Meg, and you know, to get to the point. So that opportunity is available to everybody. And so I just think it's wonderful that you're taking the leadership and both financially and. Thank you, Nick.
And
that is
so much,
such a generous gift. Thank you, Nick. And I know that not everybody's in a position to certainly do that. So the amount is not the thing that everyone is looking for. It's just the contribution of meaningful is what how we really feel. I was also going to say, Nick has just agreed to come on our board. Has had a July board meeting. He'll come back in a couple of weeks for our October board meeting. And when I asked Nick to join the board, we were really trying to have all of our board members now connect back to one of our most important strategies. Some people have been a chair of a committee like the personnel committee or something like that, more of the operational pieces, but of our mission related work, national focus, North Carolina focus, research and evaluation focus, and intern focus are the 4 that we've really just invited our some of our board members to really bring that message back to the board of directors so that they're just as familiar with it as our staff are. And so Nick will be the ambassador, sharing some of the things that we're doing and learning, and you know, our goals, so we can broaden the value that the board understands. But part of our mission really is investing and advancing the interest in prevention and public health within each of you guys and where you go, as well as building healthy places and changing lives through the organizational change. But people changes is just as powerful, if not more, because what you guys go and do outside of our work is also our mission. So thank you for that. And I was just going to say there's some other strategies we're doing in addition to I think through Building Bridges campaign, where you're building bridges, that idea. Sarah actually, when she was interning with this summer, called around and identified a potential grant opportunity, and we put together very quickly a little grant proposal to Strad Roses that to potentially help support us in order to bring in the sort of an intern coordinator. We haven't heard about that. I think we hear back in
next month.
So that might happen, and a few of us are going to go visit with the GlaxoSmithKline Foundation after the board meeting. We're looking in the museum, and we're going to go out and just talk with Marilyn Cook-Hudson about our vision. They do a lot of funding of women in health and women in science. You know, it's one of their focus areas, and not all people in our area are women, but it's a advancing the science of public health. So we're going to explore that opportunity. So we're going to be looking for other things. So if you have any thoughts or ideas about other ways we could just think about investing in young career development, let us know. We're exploring ideas right now. So any other feedback or thoughts on, I think even ways you've been, accelerated your career, as well as opportunities that you could use to advance really you're building in that we're going forward.
I think I would like to add to that, and that I'm talking still with a lot of the interns as they're moving on in their careers. That they have said that as they apply to other places, when they talk about the breadth of the work that they did here as interns, they said it clearly makes them a good candidate for a job. So, it's something that it's not only invaluable what you're doing while you're here, contributing to the organization, but it also contributes to your career possibilities. And I would expect Nick is probably a good example of that, but there are many others that we've had that they said it would really help them.
I would agree with that. I remember two very distinct moments from my internship. Well, actually, the second one I was on the team here, officially, but the first one, Melba, I don't remember what meeting it was, but
I remember.
It was a meeting, a room full of people, all very established and strong. And
directors of HR.
Yeah, I mean, really, really important people in the room. Melba and I had a conversation headed to the meeting, and I talked to her about how uncomfortable I was speaking in public and, putting my voice in the room and all of that. Melba just threw me on the spot in the meeting.
Right.
It's so uncharacteristic. Right? And it was really sink or swim, and I think I'll never.
I was holding your hand under the table.
I'll never really understand and know how important that moment was, but had I not been here, that wouldn't have happened.
Okay, and I'm going to add to that story, in that so his goal was to say something in the meeting. And he said something in the final 5 minutes of the meeting. So I said, okay, next time the goal is you have to say something. If it's an hour meeting, you have to say something in the first 15 minutes of a meeting. So again, always thinking like, what are we?
I thought I was going to get away with it. That's why. And the other moment was after having, driven literally to over 100 hospitals and having met several leaders within these hospitals that were but had very big jobs and very influential in their communities. I really fell in love with the type of work that they did, and I started to think about patterning my life and my career into healthcare administration. And I forget who told me, but someone said, hey, there's this guy over at the School of Public Health, you really need to know. He's with the MHA program, and he's really smart, knows a lot of people, just be a good person for you to talk to. And it happened to be Jeffrey. And so I looked him up online, saw his profile and everything, and drafted this email, and I looked at it for about a week, and I said, oh, I'm not gonna send this email. Who am I? He's gonna trash it anyway. Well, another 2 weeks or so went by, and I was sitting at my cubicle in the back working, and Meg walks in and says, hey, Nick, I want you to meet someone. Turn around, it's Jeffrey. I never needed the email. From there, I was able to talk to him about my interest and learn more about the program, and ultimately very purposeful was my time here.